channel, so I thought I'd try a little bit of a different video today. Just kind of a typical Sunday. Do a bit of work on Milan. So what you just saw is me coming out of my back door and looking around the front garden there and heading down towards on the path towards what is an old cheese box factory. They used to make the boxes for cheese. There's a down the road there was a cheese factory, and this was the mill where they made the wooden cheese boxes, if you're familiar with kind of old cheese practices back in the day, you'd be familiar. And I think believe this is actually where the cheese box was made for the mammoth cheese that was sent down to one of the expos in I think the late 1800s. There's actually a monument up to it in Perth. But yeah, there was a big cheese created for, I want to say it was like Chicago World Expo, or somewhere in the northern states of America. Anyway. Yeah, so you should look into mammoth cheese, it will probably come up. But yeah, this is quite a fascinating old little building, and yeah, got a bunch of work to do. We have, probably can't quite see it, but here we have tons of wild parsnip, which is an invasive species, and it's very nasty. And if you break it and get the sap on your skin, you'll get a chemical burn, very severe chemical burn. So we're trying to get rid of as much as possible, but it keeps rearing its ugly head. So just gotta keep pulling it out. You can treat it with chemicals, but I prefer not to use chemicals where I can. So if I can just put in a bit of labor, I'm fine with that. We have a ton of wildlife around here, so, and like to grow things. I probably eventually will grow some potatoes or something down here, but so I really try to avoid using any kind of pesticide or even fertilizer, really. But that's just my own personal preference. But yeah, it's a bit damp today, but I think first job of the day is to build a fire. I still have a bunch of wild parsnip dried out here that we pulled out a few weeks ago. So the only really way to get rid of it is to burn it, which kind of maybe seems a little counterproductive, but you're not allowed to, you can't put it in any municipal dump or anything. So there's not really any other way to get rid of it. So yeah, I'm gonna go build a fire. So I got the fire going. Just a little shot here. It's all nice and warm. Really good. It's got a bit going for it there. Probably do a bit of shot later on. Couldn't really show you the process because I didn't have a tripod or anything, so kind of need the two hands. But I'm gonna put the kettle on and make myself some coffee. So yeah, I just got the coffee on there. Just a little camp kettle I have. Just stick it right on the hot coals. Shouldn't take too long. The plastic handle comes right off, so it's pretty safe. Got the grounds right in there. Just once they become saturated, they sink to the bottom anyway. So. I've made fires most of my life, so I'm kind of used to being around fire. And the fire pit does look a bit overgrown, but the grass is so wet, it's not really any danger of it catching fire. I've got lots of access to water here, so I can really douse it out as well. And I'm very fire conscious, fire safe, and because we are prone prone to the fires around here just because of the a lot of farmland, a lot of dry grass and hay and stuff, but I'm very careful. But you're allowed to have a campfire, and it's early enough in the morning that's still within the required hours. It's like 6 o'clock at night to 8 o'clock in the morning, and right now it's about 6:30. So I probably won't have it going for too long, but yeah, it's always very nice to have a fire, especially on a wet day. And then it is kind of actually raining right now, but you can have, it's quite easy to start a fire in the rain. You just need dry wood in a dry spot to put it down. The worst comes to worst, you just dig up the ground a little bit, and as long as you have the dry wood, dry kindling and some fire starter, you're good to go. I've gone camping a lot of times in the fall, like October and stuff, and it's been very wet, and pretty much every time I've been able to start a fire, it's such a morale booster. I think Ray Mears says it's like one of the most important things when you're out on camp, especially in like a survival mode. It's start a fire, you can get warm, you can get dry, you can cook food, and it's just a massive, massive morale booster. So yeah, I never give up trying to make a fire when it's wet. So yeah, there, and check, see how the coffee's doing in a minute. Shouldn't take too long. It'll probably start bubbling over if it's boiling. But yeah, very much look forward to my coffee. So yeah, I hope you're kind of enjoying this slightly different video from me. So I thought I'd do a little bit of a day in the life of a vlog. Sorry, I can't really show you much of the action just because I don't have a tripod or thing, and I need two hands to do a lot of the stuff. But kind of a look around. So yesterday we went to a couple of charity shops and rehome and restore stuff, and looking around, and naturally I got a ton of books, but one in particular that I grabbed was Crudo from Olivia Lang, and I just started reading it in the car when my wife was out doing some grocery shopping and went to Winners. She just wanted me to hang out in the car with the dogs, make sure he was all right, and no point us both going in. It just doesn't really help the matter, and what with the COVID regulations still in place and stuff, like it just makes more sense for me to stay in the car. And I was very happy too with my reading, so started reading Olivia Lang's Crudo, and so far it's just so fantastic. It's pretty irreverent and funny, and it's very contemporary. It mentions a lot about recent events. I think it was written in 2017, and just right around the first year of Trump and Brexit and Grenfell, and a lot of it is it's just done very much passing. It's kind of like, it's not, I don't know if you would call it stream of consciousness, or it's more it's very in a monologue. Very strong narrative voice. So it's kind of just, it's almost told in the way of how I actually think on most days. It's this constant kind of thinking and thoughts, and how you, and it just flits from one to the other, and very much will bring something up and then immediately just move on. And it's a very me kind of novel. Very much when I read anything like literary or general fiction or public fiction that's not super genre based for like a narrative or anything, I do quite like that, just kind of more of an inner monologue. And even then, for some of my genre works, I do like a real inner monologue type book. But it has some really funny moments, and maybe a bit little thing, but it has a lot of swearing, and I am someone that swears quite a lot, and it's always nice to have someone that kind of thinks and speaks very similar to me. It just feels very relatable, and yeah, it's kind of probably the book I was looking for that I didn't know I wanted to read, and so I'm kind of racing through it, and so probably have a review up pretty shortly, and then probably move on to another Agatha Christie. Yeah, I got a bunch of other stuff as well. Like, I think I got like 20 books. It was like a dollar a book, so why not? Maybe I got a little bit less because I got a couple of hardcovers that were $2. But yeah, this is a very good book haul. I'm not sure if I'll do it on the channel or not, but I'm sure you'll see all the books very soon. So yeah, I'll just maybe do some more shots of the fire and have me drinking my coffee. Yeah, it gets a little bit warm next to the fire, but it's lovely to kind of feel the warmth of the fire even on a fairly warm summer's day. I think it's probably just under 20 right now. It's not been that warm recently. I think the other morning I was still at work and looked at the temperature about 11 o'clock and it was still under 20, so it's about 19. I think the warmer weather's about to come. But that's by the by. I still have a fire on a summer's night. It's, even if it's still 30 out. And so yeah, just pour my coffee. Even though there's grounds in it, it sinks to the bottom. So yeah, and as Michael K. Vaughan says, black coffee, nothing in it. Pretty good. Could maybe do a little bit longer, but it has a little bit of that smoky fire flavor. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it on for a bit longer, but I'll definitely drink that one. So this is one of the paths. This is the dreaded wild parsnip. This is a young one, and it's a little bit bigger. It's worse over that way than the path over there. But Yeah, my wife did a really good job creating all these paths last year. I had a little bit harder time maintaining it with us both working, especially with me working 6 days a week, but we're getting there. Got tons of new trees growing, so just find this around here in the soil, this particular part of Eastern Ontario we're in, is the soil seems so fertile. It's actually great that tomatoes and eggplants are growing so well this year. Just quite a lot of produce right now from the garden, which is absolutely fantastic, and it's kind of what we want it to be. And I think if you can grow your own food, it's always good. I mean, we don't grow enough to live completely off our own means, but we're each year we're trying to get a little bit better. And I do think that growing your own food is a radical act, and it means you're just one person, one extra thing. Just you're less sufficient on someone else. And what with the state of the world and how quickly things can change, I think, you know, we've all seen that in the past 18 months, that any little bit you can do to help kind of yourself, it's always good. But yeah, you can see how it gets a little bit overgrown here. That's no problem for me in wetness. I grew up in the UK and I grew up in the countryside, so a little bit of overgrown wet and wet is no problem for me. This is pretty much most of what I did in my childhood. It's exploring around areas. Obviously, if I was any kind of park, I've tried to stick to the footpath and whatever, but there's so much just random land and farmland and bits in the UK that you can just kind of go around exploring. Going down here, probably have to head back up to the house soon. I think my wife is up and just wants some coffee. That's all good. We have a little ritual. Take the dog out for a walk. He was gonna go earlier, but he went back up to bed when I got the leash. So I guess that was me told. Yeah, it gets a little bit more overgrown there. So let's turn back. It's also kind of hard to, we don't really know properly where the boundary lines are, but we're very good friends with our neighbors, so it doesn't really matter. Some more firewood here. Just it's the beauty of having land, is you're never short of firewood. And we don't burn fire if the heat's off. We're still in oil and changing to propane, so we just use it for campfires, which is great, because we love the old campfire. It would be nice to have a fireplace as a in the house, but that's not gonna happen with our house anytime soon. I think we still have the chimneys and everything, but it's just an extra expense to get it put in, because all the fireplace that they would have had have all gone. So yeah, we're just kind of working on that. Got a lot of other issues to deal with way before that. So yeah, we got more land this way, all pretty much overgrown. Our neighbors actually did come through here with a four-wheeler, so it's kind of a little bit better than it was. And this is kind of where our property line ends, and they have it's like a fence down here somewhere. But yeah, this pretty much just expansive farmland. It's pretty nice. Try and get onto the crest so you can see more of the horizon. But yeah, I love living out here. It's very different, but it's also very similar to where I grew up in the UK. I grew up in Wiltshire, and I was kind of in Devizes, and then I moved to Herefordshire, which is also big farming, lots of potatoes and cattle. Wiltshire was a lot of they grow canola, but they grow like oil rapeseed and other things like that, big crops. And they also had a lot of dairy farms too, a lot of cattle, a lot of sheep. My parents now live in the Lake District, which is pretty heavy sheep farming. I think we're surrounded by sheep farms. There's not a ton of sheep around here. Don't see too many. We're very cattle, dairy heavy. And also there's a fair bit of chicken farming too. But yeah, there's definitely a lot of animals in the fields, and you see the odd llamas, and they're getting a bit more popular, and some goats. And our neighbors just down the road actually have a hobby farm where they have, I think, about 12 cows, 6 goats, and sometimes chickens and guinea fowl, which are interesting. So yeah, it's more property down that way. I think at some point we're gonna mow all this, get it all cleared out, and put down a little mini cabin. Kind of like a bunkie style, like one room, bed, maybe shelves, maybe chair, some like reading, summertime, kind of nice area to sleep. It's nice and secure for the dog. We're gonna try and ingratiate him into camping probably this season. But definitely it'd be nice to have more of an enclosed space where we don't have to worry about him so much. And we have a really nice tent as well, so hoping we're gonna actually buy a cheaper tent, one we care a little bit less about to start, just so that if he wrecks it, then it's no big deal, because our big Agnes is very, very loved, and we've had it since we pretty much first got together, when we first came to Canada. So we've had it for, well, we got it just before our wedding, I guess, so we've had it for about 7 years now, I think. Oh, no, sorry, we got it in 2017, after we moved to Kingston, sorry. So we've had it for 4 years. Yeah, which very much love about Big Agnes, a good Colorado company. If you're looking for a tent, very much highly recommend them. They might be a little bit more expensive than you're looking for, but very, very much worth it. It's just like amazingly good quality. And yeah, back here. Yeah, I think I might just drink the rest of my coffee, douse the fire, and head on up to the house. Didn't really get any work done, but it doesn't matter. Just thought you all would like to see a quick snapshot into my Sunday morning routine. And maybe I'll get some more footage of me out in the front garden doing some weeding and some harvesting some tomatoes and whatnot. But otherwise, I would just leave this. I'll probably have them in separate videos anyway, just because of the length, and I'm still on satellite internet rule. Hopefully we'll get the fiber optics at the end of the year. They dug up the road already, so it's looking good. Haven't had any word from the company, but it is looking great. And yeah, so I'll see you all shortly.